Thank you. This is about printing the your two-dimensional array in the matrix. So now you know how to print the matrix in the how to print the two-dimensional array. So now we'll deal with this two dimensions for a matrix type of things, calculations, and how we're going to do. Okay. Now, first we go with the transpose of a matrix. Transpose of a matrix. So let's take first we'll calculate what is the transpose of matrix. First, when I take a two-dimensional array, yeah, 3 by 3 or 3 by 2, something 3 by 3. So now the elements will be, what are the elements? You have 0, 0. That's variable names are 0, 0 and 0, 1, and you have 0 or 2. This is the first row, and next row is you have 1, 0, A of 1, 1, A of 1, 2, and next one is A of 2, 0, A of 2, 2, so 2, 1, A of 2, 2. So these are the variable names. When I enter the values will be stored into particular variables. For example, if I'm entering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is a thing, but in the memory they will be there in this format only, but we have a thinking in terms of two dimensions. This is A of 0, 0, A of 0, 1, A of 0, 2, A of 1, 0, A of 1, 1, A of 1, 2, A of 2, 0, A of 2, 1, A of 2. So this is the variable. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But if I'm taking it, if I'm perspectively, if I'm thinking that in the matrix form, how it will be there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are the matrix. And if I'm printing, if you want to convert this into a row to a column and column to row, how should I print this? Okay, you can print it
in the for loop swap I and j.
Yes, for loop swap I value to j value. You can directly print it. Or else you can take help of another matrix, B matrix, which is empty matrix. Again, the same size. It should be the same size with the same size of this. And copy them into the B matrix by transpose. That is interchanging the variables. Or else you can directly print. Or else, for example, you for I equal to 0. Sorry. So before that, I'll explain what is this transpose. So you might know what is a transpose, but I'm telling. So here. So this is the first element. So 1, 2, 3. It should become 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, and 7, 8, 9. 7, 8, 9. It should become like this. That means here I'm writing directly the index values to understand. So this is 0, 0. This is 0, 1, this is 0, 2, this is 1, 0, this is 1, 1, this is 1, 2, this is 2, 1, 2, 0, 2, 1, 2. This is it. So whenever I have transposed it, the values became here 0, 0, this is 0, 1, this is 0, 2, now 1, 0. 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, and 2, 0, 2, 1, and 2. So this is it. That means when I've considered this is I value, this is J value, this is I value, this is J value, this is I value, this is J value, what is happening? So this is j value, this is I value. This is j value, this is I value. So this is j value, this is I value. Is that right? So it is interchanging. I 0. So 0, 0. So what is happening? First here I value 0, j value 0. So j value 0, I value 0. And here I value 0, j value is 1. So but here j value is 1, I value. So that the values are interchanged. When I transpose it, the values j and I are interchanged. How to make it is interchange? Change the for loop. Change the for loop for write with the j equal to 0, j less than column size, j plus plus. And for I equal to 0, I less than, sorry, this is I less than row size, I plus plus. Now printf, printf percentile 3d as you wish, rd and af ij, you can write like this, or else you can change, interchange this or that. So I values, j values change, j values, I values, or else you can follow this way. For I equal to 0, I less than r size, I plus plus. For j equal to 0, j less than c size, and as it is. But in the printf statement, you change, instead of ij, you change ji. Ji. So in this way also you can get. Or else you can write the same for loop and copy this b of ij equal to, b of ij equal to a of ji. A of ji. So now it will be trans, it will be, the values will be reversely transposely, they are copied into here. Same for loop, the regular for loop. Remember, to write this, you have to write regular for loop. That is for I equal to 0, I less than 0, the R size and like this. And write, instead of that, you write A of ij equal to B of ij equal to A of ji. And print B of ij. That will be in the transpose form. There are three methods. Remember, you can do this way, or you can do this way, or you can do this way. Anything is correct. Anyone is correct. You can do by three steps. But what is this is, just to, we are reading the matrix, there is two-dimensional array, and printing directly in the transpose form. Directly in the transpose form. And here in this case, what we are doing is, we are copying the transposed matrix into other new matrix, new array, and printing it. But this is also correct. This is also correct. If at all, if you asked in which way, for example, if they asked, copy the transpose matrix to another new array and print it, you can go this way or you can go this way. These are the two ways. There are three ways I've told. So you can follow any of these three. You'll be getting the answer. And remember,
sir, can you explain this copy method once again?
Explain the
copy method. That's A.
As it is, for I equal to 0, I less than R size, I plus plus. For j equal to 0, j less than C size, j plus plus. And when you're copying, what you have to do is you write as it is for B array, and you write here reverse of j and I. Close it. After that, print for I equal to 0, I less than R size, I plus plus. For j equal to 0, j less than C size, j plus plus. And print percentile 3D, B of ij. Close printf slash n. We are printing the matrix from there. So this is after that copy.
Sir, why are you using 3D percentile 3D?
A percentile 3D is we are assigning three spaces for to print that, and in that space we are allocating for every number we are allocating the three spaces to be printed, and we are printing that value. If at all if I'm printing 1 here, 2 here, 3 here, 4 here, they'll be allocating equal number of spaces. They'll be coming in the matrix form easily. So that after printing this, for example, there is 2x2 matrix, 1 2, and first they'll be assigning the three spaces like this, and they'll be assigning the same three spaces like this, three spaces after new line, three spaces like this, after new line, this three spaces like this, 3 4. We are not going to see these spaces, but what is the output we are going to get? 1 2 3 4. We have tried every exam, so everything will be getting in the correct spaces, and we are going to print it. That is the value. If at all, if it is, we are going to deal with a two digits values. You increase this space as per your requirement. Okay, that's. You can go if at all. If you don't want to do this, you can write a slash t. But you are not going to get a spaces before directly. If at all your screen is this way, you are going to get 1 2 3 4 like this. So space will be getting, but like this. If at all if you are giving 3D, the output will be 1 2 3 4 like this. Once you check it, difference how it will be getting. If at all you are giving a slash t after number, you are getting spaces, and if you are giving a number, you are getting before spaces like this. This is the difference. Okay, understood? Akhil?
Yes, sir, understood, sir.
Okay, that is about transpose of a matrix. So next we'll deal with the addition of matrices. Next, addition of two matrices. So how we are going to do addition of two matrices. So here, to make addition of two matrices, we have to take, that is, first two dimensional array and second two dimensional array, and after adding these two, we have to get a resulting two dimensional array. Is that right? Therefore, how many arrays have to declare? How many two-dimensional arrays have to declare? Three two-dimensional arrays has to declare. So declare a three two-dimensional arrays. First one is the first matrix. Second one is the second matrix. Next one is resultant matrix where we are going to store. Okay. Now, so if I'm taking a two-dimensional array, so this is the first 0 0. I'm writing. Remember. 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. This is the index of the row and column. Remember, row and column. Instead of writing a subscript, I'm directly writing. Okay. So think that. So I'm directly, instead of this writing, I've wrote like this to understand easily. Okay. So I'll write. So, okay. If there are elements in the matrix, this is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. 1 1. These are the 2x2 matrix. Okay. Now, so to add two matrix, what we have to do? We have to add this element with this element. This element with this element. I think I no need to explain how the addition of matrices will be done. So you are well known about this addition of matrices. Is that right? The place which is there here should be added here. The place which is there here should be added with this element. The place which element which is there in this place, we have to add it with this element. The place which is element here to be there here. And that means we have to give in the result again in the same, which is again 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Is that right? So that means after adding these two elements, we are going to place this element here. To get this element, what we are going to write? So that is, if this is the A array, this is the B array. That means I'm writing elaborately, I'm writing this. What is this? So this, to get this element, how we are going to get a of 0, 0 plus p of 0, 0. Is that right? To get this element, a of 0, 1 plus p of 0, 1. Next, to get this element, a of 1, 0 plus b of 1, 0 and a of 1, 1 plus b of 1, 1. Is that right? So that means we are going to get a result here. This is a resultant matrix, or else you can take C, or else you can take anything. But so resultant RES or any matrix you can take as a. Okay, but that means C of, that means what is the value here? The C of, for example, C of 0, 0, this is C, for example, this is C of 0, 0 is equal to what? A of 0, 0 plus B of 0, 0. Next, C of 0, 1 equal to A of 0, 1 plus B of 0, 1. Next, C of 1, 0 equal to A of 1, 0 plus B of 1, 0. Is that right? And C of 1, 1 equal to A of 1, 1 plus B of 1, 1. Is that right? To get the answer of this values, we are going to get same. Remember, if this is I and this is J. Is that right? This is I and this is J. This is I and this is J. Every time if I value is here same, I value is same as the all this. So it is 0, 0, it's a 0, 1 actually. So what is the I value I'm taking here in this resultant? They're same as the remaining values also. Therefore, what I'm going to write is, so this is a two dimensions. Therefore, for I equal to 0, I less than what is the row size, for example, for time being I'm taking 2 I plus plus. So for the reason I have taken 2 by 2, that's the reason I've taken. Okay, for j equal to 0, j less than 2, j plus plus. Here I'm writing, I don't fit there, so therefore I'm writing here from c of I j equal to A of ij plus B of ij. Remember, where C of ij is the resultant matrix. C is the resultant. The C variable I've taken is for the resultant matrix. Okay, this is that. That means, for example, if I value is 0 and j value is 0 is less than 2 and j value is 0 and 0 is less than 2, it is true. When 0 is 0 is equal to 0, 0, 0, 0. Is that right? First statement, C of 0, 0 equal to A of 0, 0 plus B of 0. Next, the next iteration, J value increments, 1 less than 2, as it is true. Now, C of 0, 1 is equal to A of 0, 1 plus B of 0, 1. Only J value will be incremented because we didn't go out of the inner loop. So first, we have to come out of the outer inner loop. After that, we go to outer. Therefore, 1, J value incremented to 1, 1 less than 2, as it is true. Next, we have done this statement. Next, if I increment j value becomes 2, 2 less than 2, it is false. We're coming out of the inner loop. Once we're coming out of the inner loop, so once we come out of the inner loop, we have here. So next, after that, we have to go increment I value. So I value becomes 1, 1 less than 2, as it is true. Again, j value starts with 0. So j equal to 0 and 0 less than 2, as it is true. Remember, it is true. I value is 1 and j value is 0. I value is 1, j value is 0. I value is 1, j value is 0. Therefore, what is this? The next statement, c of 1, 0 equal to a of 1, 0 plus p of 1, 0. Is that statement done? Yes, it is done. Next, after completion statement, we go here and increment the j value. So we didn't go out of the inner loop. Therefore, j value becomes 1, 1 less than 2, as it is true. We are going inside again, C of 1, 1 is equal to A of 1, 1 is equal to B of 1, 1. Yes, it is right. The next stage is the right. Yes. C of 1, 1 equal to A of 1, 1 plus B of 1, 1. Done. We are coming out of the block. And next, increment j value, j value is less than 2, less than 2, it is false. We come out of the block. So next, when we come out of the block, so we are here, we are going to increment the j value, that's i value becomes 2 less than 2, it is false. We are coming out of all for loops. Therefore, the four statements is done. If at all, your size increments, so you increase the size based upon row size and column size, you write a row size and column size. Therefore, what is the logic? To write addition of two numbers for I equal to 0, I less than row size, and I plus plus for j less than j equal to 0, j less than column size, j plus plus, and resultant matrix. What is the resultant matrix? As you wish, you can take any as is. Ij equal to P of ij plus B of ij. Simple. Semicolon, close, and close. After that, print the resultant matrix. To print a resultant matrix in the matrix form, resultant, this you have to print it. After adding it, so we have added both both matrices, this two-dimensional array, this two-dimensional array into this two-dimensional array. But we have to print this two-dimensional array in the matrix form to get the result. So how to print the two-dimensional in the matrix form? Result, I less than R size, same R size, I plus plus. Next, for j is equal to 0, j less than column size, j plus plus. Now to print it, so same print them percentile 3d and next resultant of ij and close it. After that, print them slash and close and close. Okay, done. This is for addition of two matrices. Okay, well, good. For example, we are going for addition of two matrices. For example, this is A matrix, this is B matrix. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is the addition is possible? Is the addition is possible?
No.
So therefore, what we have to do before only, when you read first, when you read, you take A matrix and B matrix, that is A two dimensional array and B two dimensional array, and you read the row size for this, you read the column size for this. If at all, if they're R1 and C1, this is R2 and C2. If it, for example, if you're reading differently, you have to check if R1 equal to R2 and C1 equal to C2. Then go and perform this addition. Note, if at all, this addition and print this value. Else, you write it, addition cannot be possible. That is the addition of the matrices not possible because the both are different sizes. Both are in different sizes. This is addition of two matrices. Done? Understood? Any doubts up to here? Anyone in the class? Just very simple. Very simple. Okay. So if it is, what is the trace of a matrix? How to find a trace of a matrix for a given two-dimensional array? So this is a two-dimensional
sum of diagonal elements.
Then how to find the sum of diagonal elements? That means here it will be 0, 1, 0, 2, 1, 0, 1, 1, 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 2. That means to find the sum of diagonal elements, I value and J value should be equal. Yes, is that right? I value and J value should be equal. So therefore, for that, what we have to write? For I equal to 0, I less than R size, I plus plus, open for J equal to 0, j less than c size j plus plus, and if you write a condition, if I equal to equal to j, you write, you perform sum. So that is what is sum. So sum equal to sum plus, the same logic, sum equal to sum plus, you have to make sum equal to zero first. Okay, sum equal to sum plus a r I j, close close close, print a sum, percentile d sum value. That this is a trace of a Gibbs matrix. So now I have told you.
Sir, this we can do by one for loop also, sir.
Do by?
By yeah. One for a I comma I, we can do, no, sir.
A I comma I. You can do that also. I comma I, you can make that also correct. I comma
yes,
I.
Sir, it's better. Complexity.
It's better. You can write a I comma I. Instead of writing a for if condition, you can directly a of I comma I. So instead of writing this other for loop also, okay, a of I comma I, you can do that well. This is like you can directly thinking in terms of matrices. Yes, that can also be done. Very good. Okay, so any doubts up to here? This is, we have discussed sum and trace and transpose. Okay, so next, next multiplication of two matrices. Then to get the multiplication of two matrices, how many two dimensional arrays I have to read a of a and b and resultant matrix. So if I multiply these two, I should get the result into this. But is that the same as addition? Can we do that as addition? How we have done for the addition, can we do the same thing in the here? No, we cannot do, because for example, so I'm taking two dimensional array, I'm taking for being a simple, so easy counted into two dimensional array. Is that right? This is the variables and we have to get the result. Then what is the result? How we are going to go for the result? To get this element, that is, let's take RES of 0, 0, RES of 0, 1, RES of 1, 0, RES of 1, to get this particular element, what is the logic we have to do? So this multiplied with this plus, and this multiplied with this. Is that right? The same thing? Did I go wrong? Is that right or something?
Correct.
Yes, correct now. So for that, I'm writing RES of 0, 0 equal to RES of 0, 0 equal to a of 0, 0 into multiplied by b of 0 0 plus a of 0 1 is equal to, sorry, a of 0 1 multiplied by p of 1 0. P of 1 0. Next, the next one, res of 0 0. This is 0 1, the next element, 0 1. To get this element, what should I do? I have to multiply this element with this element. Is that right? Sorry. Multiply with this element with this element and multiply this element plus multiply this element with this element. Is that right? Yes. Yeah. Next, 0, 0 into P of 0, 1 plus A of 0, 1 into B of 1 1 and next RES of this one to get this one. To get this one, what you have to do? Multiply this one with this one and this one with this one. Is that right? Same thing. A of RES of 1 0 is equal to next A of 1 0 multiplied by B of 0 0 plus A of 1 1 multiplied by B of 1 0. Next, to get this element, this should be multiplied with this element, this should be multiplied with this one. Next, RES of 1 1 is equal to A of 1 0 multiplied by B of 0 1 plus A of 1 1 multiplied by P of 1 1. Yes, these are the statements we should get. But how we are to get? Is there any possible? Because here we need to deal with two things. Here we have one multiplication and addition, So this thing have to multiplied and added with this multiplication again. So how we can do that? So that can be done by using three for loops and one temporary inner for loop. One temporary inner for loop that can be done. I'm erasing here. I'm going to write there. So instead of writing here, I'm starting from here. Okay, so I forgot writing for loop. Here the combination, for example, there is first one is R1, C1, R2, and C2. What is this? Whenever we go for a multiplication, which one should be common? These should be common. Then we can perform the multiplication. C1 equal to R2. Then in that case, we'll go for the multiplication. Then so you have to write here either C1 or R2. You can write anything. Okay, so put all these R1 and C1. So, but here this should be R1, this should be C2. The resultant matrix will be, what is the resultant matrix? R1 and C2. Therefore, here R1 and C2, and this can be either it is C1 or either it can be R2. So anything can, sir, be. Yeah.
Is there a way to know the size, like dimensions of a 2D array?
There is an, yes, you are going to submit, we are going to take the dimensions of the 2D array.
Like without taking input.
Yes.
Without taking input.
How you are going to, without taking input, how you are going to declare your 2D array? This size, how you are going to declare?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Okay. So therefore, did you understood? This is R1, C2, and it can be C1 or it can be R2 as you wish. Okay, and K++. And inside this, you write RES of IJ equal to RES of IJ plus. Here I'm writing in the down, it should be continuation. A of I K into P of K J. Close, close, and close. This is the logic. So once we'll see that. So how it will there for 2 by 2. So this is 2 and this is 2 and this is 2. Is that right? 2 by 2, I'm checking. It can be variable size or it can be anything, but for time being, I'm checking it is 2 by 2. So as we have taken 2 by 2 size to explain here. So first I equal to 0 and 0 is less than 2. Is that true? Yes, it is true. I'm writing here I equal to 0. Next, we are going to inside the block, inside of the block for I, j equal to 0 and 0 is less than 2, yes, it is true. And j value is also 0. Now, next, what I have done, RES of IJ, what is I value? 0 and j value? 0. So therefore, RES of I value 0 and j value 0. It is equal to 0. I've assigned which one? The first variable, the 0 equal to 0. Because what is the reason I've given assigned to 0? Because inside of this, what is this? RES equal to RES plus. Because you should have some value here. Which value I'm starting with? 0. Because we are having here multiplication along with addition. Multiplication along with addition. Multiplication along with addition. Therefore, first, after multiplying these two variables, so we have to add this variable with this. Other, after multiplying this, we have to add this result with this result. That means what I'm going to do is I'm calculating this result first time, and after calculating this result first time, I'm storing this into this variable, that's RES variable. After that, I'm multiplying this and storing that is both values addition into this. So that's the reason I wrote RES of IJ equal to RES of IJ plus A of K of ij ik into b of kj. That is how it is goes on. We'll see now. So k equal to 0. I'll take other pen because to understand. What is the time? Okay. So I'll be fast. So now this is I value is equal to 0 first, j value is equal to 0, and res of 0 and 0 is equal to 0 I've assigned. Okay, now this is 2 and this is 2, and 0 is less than 2 as it is true, and 0 is less than 2, this is true, and we came here, we assigned to 0. Now k is equal to 0. Yes, done. 0 is less than c2. What is again? It is also 2. So this is 2 by 2 and 2 by 2. So however, this is same. So 2 only. Therefore, 0 is less than. Next, here res. First, we are going to calculate this right part and we have to save it to left side. So res of 0, I value 0, j value. What is I value 0 and j value 0? So the res of 0, 0, what is the value of res of 0, 0? This is 0. A plus and a of all are same. So all are 0. I value 0, j value 0, k value 0. Therefore, this 0, 0 into this b of 0, 0. So what is the a of 0, 0? So a of 0, 0, b of 0. So what is the, what I have found out, res of 0, 0. So that is res of 0, 0 equal to a of 0, 0 into b of 0. Is that this statement? In this statement, I found that res of 0, 0 is equal to a of 0, 0 into b of 0, 0. This thing I have found. Next, I have to find this one and I have to store this into same again dashboard. So we have completed the statements in the inner loop of k loop. We didn't go out to the j loop. So therefore, we have, after this statement, we should go and increment the k value. So k value will become 1. What is the k value now? K value is equal to 1. Now, take this. So does I value j value change? No, I value j is 0, j value 0. Does I value j value change? No, 0, 0. Next. Here k value changed. So k value changed. So therefore k value, this is 1 and this is 1. Now in the previous case, what is the result which I've stored here in the RES of 0, 0 only? No. So something will be there that in the 0, 0. Therefore, that is in the previous case. For example, there is like some case, this is in this case, this is 1, this is 2, 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 1. 3, 5, for example. So after multiplying these two, there is 1, 1, this is 1 into and b of 0, 0. So 1, 1, and the result will be stored into RES of 0, 0. So over this again 0, 0, plus when the next iteration, the value will be here. What is the value? That we didn't go out to the block. Therefore, what is the value? This is 1 again plus 1 plus again multiplying a of 0, 1. That is a of 0, 1 into b of 1, 0, b of 1, 0, statement. So that means after that completion, we go and increment the k value becomes a 2, 2 less than 2, it is false, we come out of the which block here. Again, we increment the j incrementation, now j value becomes 1, again k will start 0. So we go with the second statement. So you get, that means what is the k, what is the purpose of k is for this? Multiplying these two, again adding this two times. How many times we have to go? So if at all other variables, three variables are there, we have to go with add three times. Therefore, this for loop will be, inner for loop will be for the temporary to multiply these two values and to multiply these two values, add two values to get this result. This is the use of k. And next, this one. So this, what is the use of this one? In the first, when you are going to enter, we don't have what is the value, which is 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. Therefore, we are going to write this statement and after that. So I'm writing a totally, what is the calculation? I zero. Here I'm writing R1, C1, R2, C2 in the case of R1, C1. Okay. Sorry. I plus plus for j equal to 0, j less than C2, j plus plus. And that is the resultant res of I j is equal to 0. Next, for k equal to 0, k less than here, either it can be c1 or r2. You can write anything, okay? C1 or r2. So I'm writing, you can write anything, r2 I'm writing, okay? So k plus plus, similar, we have to write RS of ij equal to RS of ij plus ij plus a of ik into b of kj. So this is the formula. Close and close for this and close for this. This is the thing. So I'll detail, I'll explain in the next class. But you write this. So afterward I've explained, but up to matrix, I'll explain. Again, the matrix I'll be, matrix multiplication I'll be explaining. But up to the trace, what you have done, trace of the matrix, you have a doubt, you can ask, or else you can leave. Okay. I'm taking attendance. After taking attendance, if you want to, if you have a doubt, you can hear, you can see here. If you want to leave, you can leave. 71.
Present, sir.
72.
Present, sir.
73 absent. 74.
Present, sir.
75.
Present, sir.
76.
70. Present.
77.
Present, sir.
78.
Present, sir.
79.
Present, sir.
80.
Present, sir.
81.
Present, sir.
82.
Present, sir.
83.
Present, sir.
84.
Present, sir.
85.
Present, sir.
86.
Present, sir.
87.
Present, sir.
88.
Present, sir.
89.
Present, sir.
90.
Present, sir.
91.
Present, sir.
92.
Present, sir.
93.
Present, sir.
94.
Present, sir.
95.
Present, sir.
96 absent. Okay. 97.
Yes, sir.
98. Run out. 99.
Present, sir.
100. 101.
102. Present, sir.
103.
Present, sir.
104.
Present, sir.
105.
Present, sir.
106.
Present, sir.
107.
Yes, sir.
108. Present, sir. 109.
110. 109, present, sir.
Sir, what about 108?
Don't know, sir. 108.
110.
Not 8, present, sir.
110.
Sir. 110, present, sir.
111.
Present, sir.
112.
Present, sir.
113.
Present.
114.
Present, sir.
115. 116.
Present, sir.
117.
Present, sir.
118.
Present, sir.
119.
Present, sir.
120.
Present, sir.
121.
Yes, sir.
122.
Present, sir.
123.
Sir.
123.
Present, sir.
124.
Present, sir.
125. 125 absent. Okay. 126.
Present, sir.
127.
Sir, 125. Present, sir. Sorry, sir. Mike.
127.
125.
Present, sir.
128.
Present, sir.
29.
Present, sir.
130.
Present, sir.
131.
Present, sir.
132. 132.
Present, sir.
133.
Present, sir.
134.
133 last.
Sorry. Okay.
Sir, 101 present, sir.
ఏం చేస్తున్నావు
సార్ డిస్కనెక్ట్ అయ్యింది సార్ సార్
120
ప్రెజెంట్
ఓకే ప్రెజెంట్
సార్ 120
yes yes డాక్యుమెంట్ ఇస్ 73 96 98 ఓకే డన్ ఓకే యు కెన్ లీవ్
సార్
సారీ
ప్రెజెంట్ సార్
హూ ఇస్ దట్
76 ప్రెజెంట్
ఆ 76 ప్రెజెంట్ ఐ సెడ్ 96
సార్ ఐ యామ్ చంద్ర
I said 96, not 76.
Okay, sir.
Any doubts? Madhav and Guru. Shall I close the meeting?
No, sir. No.
Shall I close the meeting?
Yes, sir.
Okay.